Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hello everyone. Welcome back to the another tutorial. So in this tutorial, we will cover MCQs from 41 up to 50. And this is the name of the chapter is DC motor. And this is chapter 18 of Honda. Okay, so the first MCQs is in base of DC shunt motor, as the load is increased, the speed of the motor. So actually, in shunt motor, the flux remain constant. And we know that the torque is directly proportional to flux times current. So my torque is directly proportional to armature current. So if you increase the load, so increasing load means you are increasing the torque. You will require a huge torque. So for high torque, you must have a high armature current. And we also know that the speed is directly proportional to EB, which is the back EMF divided by flux. So in shunt motor, the flux remains constant. So my speed of the shunt motor depends only on the back EMF. And we also know that the voltage, supply voltage, is equal to EB plus IARA. So let's say the supply voltage is constant. So if this is constant, and if you increase the armature current, then back EMF should decrease. Or if you increase the back EMF, then the armature current should decrease. This term should decrease. So in this case, load increase. So load increase means I will require a high torque. So high torque will require high armature current. So if you increase the armature current, then the back EMF should decrease. And if the back EMF decreases, then your speed will decrease. But in shunt motor, this will decrease slightly. So it will not remain constant, but it will decrease slightly. So if you draw a curve like this, so the curve will be like this. If here I have speed and here I have torque. So if you increase the load, it means if you increase the torque, then then the speed will not be constant like this, but it will decrease slightly. It will decrease slightly like this. Okay, next MCQs is regenerative braking on shunt motor is used when the load is variable, the load is constant decrease, the load has our honey characteristic. So braking means to stop something, and regenerative braking does not stop anything. Rather, it is used to control the speed of the motor driving load such as locomotive, elevators, crane, hoist. We use regenerative braking for controlling the speed of all these components. Okay, so the regenerative braking is such braking in which the energy of the driving machinery, let's say in locomotive, here we have a wheel, okay, and along with this wheel, here we have a armature of the motor. This is north and this is south. So regenerative is such braking in which the energy of the driving machinery return back to the supply. So now the question is how this is possible, that the energy of the driving machinery return back to the supply. Actually, when we give the supply voltage, then during that back EMF will be less than the supply voltage, and current will flow like this. But when the speed of this load, our hauling load, is greater than the no load speed, then what will happen? Then the current, instead of flowing like this, current will flow like this. And in this case, your EB will be greater than voltage. So when your EB is greater than voltage, then it means this motor is now a generator. And in the supply, instead of giving voltage, supplying current, it consume current. And this happen when the overhauling load acts as a prime mover. Okay? So when this acts as a prime mover, then your motor will become a generator. So regenerative braking on shunt motor, and this motor is actually the shunt motor, is used when the load has overhauling characteristic. C is the correct answer. Okay, next MCQ is, in rheostat braking for DC series motor, the motor is run as reduced speed, motor is reversed in direction, motor is run as a generator. So actually we have rheostat braking and we have regenerative braking. So rheostat braking is also called a dynamic braking. And it is used in electric traction motor as a generator when slowing a vehicle, such as locomotive. It is called rheostat braking when generated electrical power is dissipated as heat. When the generated electrical power is dissipated as heat, then it is called rheostat braking. And it is called regenerative braking when the power is returned to the supply. So this is the main difference, return to supply. If you want to dissipate heat, then you will use series motor. And here we will use shunt motor. So motor is run at reduced speed? No. Motor is reversed in direction? No. Motor is run as a generator? So yes, motor is run as a generator. Okay, next MCQ is, in Hopkinson test for DC motor, both motor are run as a generator, both machines are mechanically coupled, both motors run at their respective rated speed of the motor are separately controlled. So actually in Hopkinson test we use two identical shunt motor, and your shunt motor must be identical, and we use this two identical shunt machine. I am using word machine because in these two shunt machine, one is the shunt motor and another one is the shunt generator. And we use this test to measure the full load losses. Or you can say that to measure the efficiency of DC machine. So in this case, both machines are mechanically coupled. So option B will be the correct answer. Okay, next MCQ is, a 230 volt DC series motor is connected to 230 volt AC supply, then it will run smoothly, it will stop, it will burn out, it will run with less efficiency and high spark. So actually, if you have a series motor and if you have DC series motor, so it means this motor required DC supply. But if you give supply to this motor and that supply is AC, so then actually this required this supply, fluctuating DC. But if you provide them this supply, which is AC, then for this interval of time, current will flow in this direction. So, but this is DC series motor, which means that it will allow current in only one direction and will not allow the current in the other direction. But if the supply electron will move in this direction, and for some interval of time, electron will want to move in this direction, but this motor will not allow them to move in the opposite direction because this is the DC series motor. So electron will lose all of its energy in this motor during this interval. So electron will jump and want to move in the opposite direction because of the AC supply. So it will run with less efficiency because there will be lots of heat will generate in this this motor, so it will have less efficiency and high spark because of the de-excitation of the electron. So option D will be the correct answer. Okay, next MCQ is,
a DC series motor should always be started on load, always run at constant load, is not suitable for high starting torque, may run away if the field get open. Option B is always run at constant speed. So for constant speed, we use the shunt motor. Is not suitable for high starting torque. It is suitable for high starting torque because for high starting torque, we mostly use series motor, and series have high starting torque in all other four types of the motor. And shunt motor have constant speed. And DC motor have very less starting resistance. Starting resistance in series motor is very low. So that's why we connect an external resistance during starting, or you should always be started on load. Because if you start it without load, then it will gain a very high speed, or you can say that it will gain an infinite speed. So, okay, so option A is the correct answer. Okay, next time MCQ is, which figure represent the speed torque characteristic for a DC shunt motor, A, B, C, D? So there is only two figures is given to us. So it means there is some sort of mistake. So actually the curve will be like this. If here I am taking speed and let's say this is the torque. So, and this will be torque. So if you increase the torque, then the speed for this shunt motor, the speed is decreased, but that is slightly. So this is the constant speed and the speed will be like this. So the curve should be like this. So in book that said that option C will be the correct answer. So I think this is a DC option. Okay, next MCQ is, which DC motor have approximately constant speed, series motor, shunt motor, cumulative compound motor, of the above? So actually that is the shunt motor have constant speed, and curve will be like that as I already discussed in MCQs 47. Okay, next MCQs is, the armature current of a DC motor is given by EB is equal to back EMF. So we need to find the armature current for a motor. So actually for motor, the equation will be like this, V is equal to EB plus IARA. So we need to find the armature current, so that will be equal to E minus EB divided by RA, and that's equal to IA. So option B will be the correct answer. Okay, next MCQ is, which motor will have highest percentage increase of input current for the same percentage increase in torque? Series motor, shunt motor, cumulative compound motor, all will have same percentage increase. So actually the correct option is option B, that is the shunt motor. So if you have constant load, so it means, let's say the figure for the shunt generator is like this. Here I am supplying voltage and this is current I. So if you increase the load, then the demand of armature current will high. So if you increase the load, it means you are increasing the torque. So if you increase the torque, then in shunt motor, the armature current should be high. So the demand of the armature current will get high, so your input current will get increased. But the question is, highest percentage increase of input current for the same percentage increase in torque. If we apply the same load over here and also apply the same load to this motor, so in this case, the resistance of this field is high. Our shunt is high, so less current will flow in this. So majority of the input current flow in this armature. So if you increase the load, so it means the current will get high. So this high, some percentage current will flow in this, but that percentage will be smaller because our shunt is high, and large percentage will flow in this, that is IA. And here we also need current for generating the field. But in this case, we use only one current for generating the field, then this same current will also flow in the armature block. So the percentage increase in this case will be high as compared to this case. So option B will be the correct answer. So this is the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.